وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
My beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, I now want to go into speaking about the shubuhat, the doubts that the orientalists and the missionaries and the disbelievers in general have brought forward regarding the Qur'an. And even some people who claim Islam, doubts that they have put forward regarding al-Islam and the Qur'an in specific. My beloved brothers and sisters, what I want to say to you all is that إن أعداء الإسلام لا يألون جهدا للطعن بهذا الدين العظيم. The enemies of Islam, they are never going to hold back in slandering this religion, whether it be slandering the one who came with this religion, being Allah Azza wa Jalla, or the Messenger Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, or even the Qur'an. They will slander every single one of them, and they won't hold back. They did this when the message of Islam started. The disbelievers, they came. Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala tells us in the Qur'an, وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا إِنْ هَذَا إِلَّا إِفْكٌ إِفْتَرَاهُ وَأَعَانَهُ عَلَيْهِ قَوْمٌ آخَرُونَ فَقَدْ جَاءُوا ظُلْمًا وَزُورًا وَقَالُوا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ اكْتَتَبَهَا فَهِيَ تُمْلَى عَلَيْهِ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا قُلْ أَنزَلَهُ الَّذِي يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفُورًا رَحِيمًا وَقَالُوا مَا لِهَذَا الرَّسُولِ يَأْكُلُ الطَّعَامَ وَيَمْشِي فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ لَوْلَا أُنْزِلَ إِلَيْهِ مَلَكٌ فَيَكُونَ مَعَهُ نَذِيرًا أَوْ يُلْقَى إِلَيْهِ كَنْزٌ أَوْ تَكُونُ لَهُ جَنَّةٌ يَأْكُلُ مِنْهَا وَقَالَ الظَّالِمُونَ إِن تَتَّبِعُونَ إِلَّا رَجُلًا مَسْحُورًا انظر كيف ضربوا لك الأمثال فضلوا فلا يستطيعون سبيلا. They slandered the Quran. They said, فَيَتُمْلَ عَلَيْهِ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. The Quran is dictated for the Prophet day and night. Someone is standing over him and is dictating to him. And Muhammad is writing. They know he doesn't write. They know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, this Quran did not come from anyone other than Allah. They know it. The eloquency, the beauty, the miracle of the Quran. They can see it. They're Arab. Aqhah. They're just being stubborn and hard-headed. They slander him, alayhi salatu wasalam, by saying that he is a person who is deceived, a person who is possessed, a person who is a magician. Yani they held back. They did not hold back in slandering the Prophet and the Quran itself. So it shouldn't be any shock to us that the enemies of Islam today are doing the same thing. The shaitan that sent revelation on those ones is the same shaitan that sent revelation on these ones to slander the religion, the Prophet, and our masadir, our sources where we take our legislation from. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he tells us in the Quran that our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam told his companions to not eat the corpse, the dead corpse of the animals. We're not allowed to eat it unless it's slaughtered in the halal way. Yani it is slaughtered in the way that the Sharia sanctioned by saying Bismillah and etc. So the disbelievers of that time, Kufar Quraysh, they sent letters, and they had a very good relationship with the Persian Empire. So they used to send letters to them. So the Persians sent a letter back to Kufar Quraysh, saying to them that your friend, yani Muhammad, from you, Quraysh, who claims he's a prophet from Allah, he prohibits his followers from eating the dead corpse. And on the same side, he claims that he follows the commandments of his Lord. He claims that he follows his Lord, Allah Azza wa Jalla. And he tells his followers not to eat the dead corpse. When the dead corpse are animals that have been slaughtered by Allah with the golden blade, with a golden sword. That's what the Zoroastrians used to believe. The Zoroastrians, they believed, and it was the belief of the Majusiyin, the Zoroastrianism, their belief is that the dead animals are slaughtered by God Himself, Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's what they believe. he slaughters it with a golden blade. So they say Muhammad is saying to his followers and his companions, do not eat from those dead corpses. It's haram from you. But what I slaughter and my followers slaughter is halal. They said it's a contradiction. Allah sent down a verse in this particular issue, on this particular situation. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, he said, وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُذْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقٌ وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أُولِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ وَإِنْ أَطَعْتُمُوهُمْ إِنَّكُمْ لَمُشْرِكُونَ. Muhammad and your followers, do not eat. وَلَا تَأْكُلُوا مِمَّا لَمْ يُذْكَرِ اسْمُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَإِنَّهُ لَفِسْقٌ. Do not eat from these dead corpses. They are fisq. They are harmful. They are prohibited from you. They are transgression if you eat from it. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أُولِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ. The shaytan is sending a revelation on these people. يعني the shayateen, the Persian shayateen, are sending advices to the shayateen of Quraysh. They are talking to each other. وَإِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ لَيُوحُونَ إِلَىٰ أُولِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ. The reason why they're doing this, doubts that they're bringing to the Muslims, is to argue with you. Allah says in another ayah, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَىٰ بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا وَلَوْ شَاءَ رَبُّكَ مَا فَعَلُوا فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, the shayateen al-ins and the shayateen al-jinn, they talk to one another. They send whispers to one another. The reason they do that is they want to harm the Muslims, the believers of Allah. They are planning and plotting against them. With what? زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. Decorative speech based on delusion and fooling the Muslims. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us, stay away from them. Leave them. فَذَرْهُمْ وَمَا يَفْتَرُونَ. Stay away from them. Leave them and that which they are calling you to and the falsehood that they are trying to spread. The reason why I'm mentioning all of this is that it is sad, wallahi, to be at a time and live at a time where you see Islam being slandered. And that's something, it's going to happen. We already know it happened before and we know it's going to happen until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the hour to come. And if people are going to slander the religion, they're going to slander our references, our religion, it's going to be going on. But what is really sad is that you find Muslims who listen to them, who want to hear what they have to say. Not only do they listen to them, but these individuals claim that they are educated people, that they are scholars, that they are graduates from this or that university, that they have understanding of the religion, and that they are deep thinkers and intellectuals. Ma'adharik, they give weight to those statements that come from the non-Muslims as though they are revelation. And they undermine and put down the statement that comes from Allah Azza wa Jalla and that which comes from the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and that which comes from the early scholars of Islam, referring to all of them as medieval, degrading them, belittling them. But then the arguments and the shubuhat and the doubts that are brought by orientalists and missionaries and disbelievers, who in Islam, they weigh nothing to Allah Azza wa Jalla. Their statements are glorified, venerated in the eyes of the people. This shows that this person or this individual lacks basic, the abjadiyat, the basics of Al-Islam. The poet, he said, فَلَيْتَ شِعْرِ مَنْ أَبَاحَ ذَلِكَ وَأَوْرَطَ الْأُمَّةَ فِي الْمَهَالِكَ فَيَا شَدِيدَ الطَّوْلِ وَالْإِنْعَامِ إِلَيْكَ نَشْكُو مِحْنَةَ الْإِسْلَامِ. Who is the person who allows such a thing? And allow something like that to take place. To Allah Azza wa Jalla, we complain our problems and the hardship that we see taking place around the world. Also, what the second muqaddimah I want to put forward, inshaAllah ta'ala, today is that this religion is going to be protected by Allah Azza wa Jalla, especially the Qur'an. Allah is going to protect it. It doesn't need me or anyone else. Allah placed it on himself. He said that he will protect it. Inna nahnu nazzalna al-dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidhun. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, we have sent down the revelation. We have sent down this Qur'an and we are going to protect it. Allah is going to protect it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it will be protected ila an yarith Allahu al-ardha wa man 'alayha. Until the day of judgment, it will be protected like this, the Qur'an. Preserved. Ahabba man ahab wa abghadha man abghad. Let the one who loves it, love it, and the one who hates it, hate it. It's going to be protected. It's a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The promise that comes from Allah is more beloved to us and means more to us than any individual. The fact Allah says, إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا ذِكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. We trust Allah, we believe in Allah. We are never going to move away from believing in that statement of Allah. Brothers and sisters, the orientalists, the missionaries, they don't have a revelation from God. Their religion is distorted. They have nothing to go back to. And so what they are trying to do is, because we don't have it, you should also have it. That's what it is. As the Arab poet says, أُقْتُلُونِي وَمَالِكًا وَقْتُلُوا مَالِكًا مَعِي. Kill me and Malik, and kill Malik with me. What does he mean by that? He means, I have committed the crime. It's treason. I did treason. I committed the crime. But kill Malik with me as well. Let me and Malik be killed together. No, you admitted that you've done treason. Malik hasn't admitted to treason. You see, we say to the Orientalists and the missionaries and the Christians, you guys have admitted that your references, your resources, your religion, you've distorted it. You have nothing to go back to. But what you're trying to do is you're trying to say, let us and the Muslims be together on this issue. No, we deny it. We say we have a preserved book. Our book is preserved. Min indillah has come from Allah. Word for word, letter by letter, nothing has been changed. And we will fight for that as long as we breathe on this earth to prove that our religion hasn't been changed. But our arguments, brothers, we don't care whether it convinces them or not, or whether they like it or not. It doesn't bother us. They might take it from us, alhamdulillah. If they don't take it, they're the ones that are going to burn in the hellfire. That's why I say to so many people, brothers, Islam doesn't need you, you need Islam. Don't be generous to anyone else. Don't be kind to anyone else. Be kind to yourself by becoming a Muslim. Because the one you're going to save from the hellfire is your own bones and flesh. That's what it is, wallah. This religion doesn't need us. The last and final point that I want to say is that these doubts that are brought are again just doubts. They are nothing concrete. And inshallah ta'ala, as we go through one after the other, you will see that bi-idhnillahi kareem. The first doubt, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to start with, and I feel like this doubt is the stepping stone to the many doubts that they put forward. And if inshallah ta'ala, we block this door, we lock off this door, then inshallah ta'ala, they have nowhere to come in. So that's why this doubt, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to break it into 5 episodes, inshallah ta'ala, because it's a very big doubt. So 5 episodes I'm going to be answering it. One is this episode, inshallah ta'ala, and 4 more episodes after that. The first doubt is bi'adami tawatur al-qira'at. The qira'at has not been transmitted in multitude narration. It's not through mass transmission. You Muslims are lying. That's what they say. It's not mass transmission. Rather, it has come in few narration. Rather, one or two people have actually narrated it. And some have gone even further by saying it is ahadiyyah. It's just ahad, singular. And here, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to prove that in 5 ways. The first way is ijma'u a'immatil muslimina. The Muslims unanimously, by consensus, agree that in order to accept a recitation, to be a Qur'an, tawatur is a prerequisite. It's a condition. In order to say this is a Qur'an, the condition is that it meets a tawatur. So I'm going to prove ijma'u a'immatil muslimin ala ishtirat at-tawatur fi naqli al-Qur'an wal-qira'at. that the imams of the Muslims unanimously, by consensus, I said, have conditioned mass transmission in the transmission of the Qur'an and the qira'at. I'm going to mention five imams. I'm going to mention what? Five imams. The first one of them is none other than Al-Imam Al-Nawawi rahimahullah. Al-Imam Al-Nawawi died the year 676 Hijriah. He said in the Sharh al-Sahih Muslim, he said, Al-Qur'an, the Qur'an, la yathbutu illa bittawaturi bil-ijma'. He said that the Qur'an is not established illa bittawaturi bil-ijma'. Except by mass transmission, and this is a matter of consensus, he said. It's a unanimous agreement that this can only be established as to be a Qur'an from Allah if it came by way of mass transmission. And this is a matter, he said, is consensus amongst the Muslims. Good. That's who? Al-Imam al-Nawawi. Intaha kalam. Now I'm going to go to the kalam of Al-Imam Abu Sa'id ibn Lub. He said, and he died the year 782 Hijriah. He has a kitab called Fathul Bab wa Raf'ul Hijab bi ta'qibi ma waqa'a fi tawatur al-Qur'an min as-su'ali wal-jawab. He said, قد اتفق علماء الأصول على أن القرآن يجب أن يكون متواترا. He said, قد اتفق علماء الأصول على أن القرآن يجب أن يكون متواترا. He said, the scholars of أصول الفقه unanimously agree على أن القرآن, that the Quran يجب, it is obligatory, أن يكون متواترا. قد اتفق, unanimously agreed upon, consensus of the أصوليين, علماء أصول الفقه, they all unanimously agree على أن القرآن, that the Quran يجب أن يكون متواترا, it has to be متواتر. Has to be متواتر. There's no difference in this issue. إجماع. He's transmitting a ijma', a unanimous agreement that the condition for us to consider this to be a Qur'an, it has to be mass transmission, multitude narration. Al-Imam ibn Lubbin rahimahullah also said something else in the same book. He said, لم يثبت في القراءات. This is qira'at. It has not been found. It is not present in the qira'at. All of it, he said. قول بعدم التواتر, a statement that tawatur is not a condition. يعني there is no statement of any scholar, he said, that said mass transmission is not a condition for qira'at. There isn't. والإجماع منصوب لإمام متقدم عالم شهير. The early scholars of Al-Islam, the early a'imma, all of them said this. He said it's not present, there's no statement of any alim from the mutaqaddimin, the early scholars, okay, who said the qira'at doesn't have to be mutawatir, or it's not a condition for, tawatur is not a condition for the qira'at. No, no one said that. وَإِنَّمَا أَضَافَ النَّاسِ, but the people attributed this, he said, مَذْهَبًا لِبَعْضِ مَنْ مَضَى مِنَ الرَّوَافِضِ, statements that have been attributed to some of the Rawafid, some of the Rawafida, wal Malahida, and people of heresy, limaqasidin fasidin qasaduha kufran wa dalala. And these people, these Malahida, these Rawafid, they had bad intent, disbelief, and misguidance in why they said qira'at is not mutawatir, or mutawatir is not a condition for the qira'at. They wanted to undermine the qira'at. They did this what? قَصَدُوهَا كُفْرًا وَضَلَالًا, he said. They did this disbelief and misguiding the people and misguiding themselves. So this imam, as I mentioned, Abu Sa'id ibn Lubbin, he died the year 800, 782 Hijriya. He's the 8th century Imam. He's saying there isn't. No one said it from the Mutaqaddimin. I've given you two Imams. An Imam al-Nawawi and also Abu Sa'id ibn Lubbin. Now I'm going to give you the statement of al-Imam Abu al-Qasim Muhibbiddin al-Nuwayri rahimahullah, who died the year 857. He died 857 Hijriya. He is the student of al-Imam al-Jazari rahimahullah. And I want you to remember that point. It's very important for me. He's the student of al-Imam al-Jazari rahimahullah, Ibn al-Jazari. He's the student of al-Imam Ibn al-Jazari. He met him in Mecca. The month was Rajab when he met him. 828 Hijriya he met him. 29 years before Abu al-Qasim Muhibbuddin al-Wayri died. He met him and he took the knowledge of the Qur'an from him. Qira'at. Muhibbuddin al-Wayri. And he has a sharh on the Tayyibah. Tayyibah al-Nashr of Al-Imam al-Jazari, Ibn al-Jazari. He has a sharh on it, an explanation on it. Okay? And it's matbu' mutadawal. It's published and you will find it. He mentions something. I want you to remember this. The reason why I'm telling you that Abu al-Qasim Muhibbuddin al-Nuwayri is a student of Ibn Rajab, Ibn al-Jazari. He's a student of Ibn al-Jazari. And that he met him. And he took the qira'at from him. And that he's also commenting on the book of his teacher. The teacher of his teacher Ibn al-Jazari, Tayyibat al-Nashr, he's commenting on it. All this information is vital. It's going to help us for some points that we're going to come to later, inshallah ta'ala. He says, please ponder on this point. He says, when he came to the statement of those imams who say, Sihatu Sanad, the authentic chain is enough. It doesn't have to be mutawatir. He's refuting them. He's debunking them. Who are not conditioned multitude narration. Who are not conditioning mass transmission, he's debunking them. In specific, he's debunking his own teacher, Ibn al-Jazari. And we'll come to that later, inshallah ta'ala. He says, هذا قول حادث. This statement is a newly invented view. It's new. مخالف لإجماع الفقهاء والمحدثين. It opposes the ijma' of the fuqaha, the jurists, and the muhaddithin. And other than them, كما ستراه إن شاء الله تعالى. As you're going to see, he said. And then he went on to say after that, فلا بد من حصول التواتر عند أئمة المذاهب الأربعة. الإمام أبو حنيفة, الإمام مالك, الإمام الشافعي, and الإمام أحمد. All four of them condition tawatur in the qira'at and the Quran. The four imams of the madhab that we follow, all four of them unanimously agree that there must be tawatur. ولم يخالف منهم أحد. None of them disputed one another in this issue. فيما علمت, he said, as much as I know of, بعد الفحص الزائد, after I researched deeply into this issue, he's saying. وصرح به جماعات, he said, وصرح به جماعات, a group of people have clearly said, لا يحصون, a large quantity of people have said that the tawatur is a condition. La yuhsawun, these people cannot be counted. He says, I can't count who they are, who've said tawatur is a condition. And then he gave examples like Ibn Abdul Barr, Ibn Atiyya, Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Tunusi, Fi Tafsiri, Ibn Nawawi, Ibn Subki, Ibn Isnawi, Ibn Adra'i, Ibn Zarkashi, Ibn Dumayri, Ibn Hajib, Ibn Shaykh Khalil, Ibn Arafa, wa ghayrihim. Other than them, all of these imams he mentioned. وَأَمَّا الْقُرَّى فَأَجْمَعُوا فِي أَوَّلِ الزَّمَانِ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. Now he goes to the reciters of the Quran, أئمَّةُ الْقِرَاءَاتِ. He says, وَأَمَّا الْقُرَّى, as for the قُرَّى, فَأَجْمَعُوا, unanimously they agreed. إِجْمَعَ amongst themselves. فِي أَوَّلِ الزَّمَانِ, the early scholars of qira'at, they unanimously agreed, عَلَى ذَلِكَ in that matter. وَكَذَلِكَ فِي آخِرِهِ, and they also agreed on its last. وَلَمْ يُخَالِفْ مِنَ الْمُتَأَخِرِينَ, and no one opposed this issue, إِلَّا أَبُو مُحَمَّدْ مَكِّي. Abu Muhammad Makki ibn Abi Talib is the only one who went against his view. وَتَبِعَهُ بَعْضُ الْمُتَأَخِرِينَ, and some of the mutaakhirin followed him in this, like Ibn Salah, Ibn al-Jazari, Abu Shamat al-Maqdisi, and others. They followed that view. And their view, مُخَالِفٌ لِلْإِجْمَعِ, goes against the ijma'. And inshallah, we're going to discuss their view, inshallah ta'ala, and tackle it bi-ithnillahi al-kareem. Also, I'm now going to mention the last and final view of one great imam, the great Maliki scholar, the great Maliki scholar, the Maliki jurist, Abu Bakr ibn al-Arabi, who died in the year 543 Hijriah. He said in his tafsir, Ahkam al-Qur'an, his tafsir book, he says, إِنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لَا يَثْبُتُ إِلَّا بِنَقْلِ التَّوَاتُرِ وَالْمَعْنَى فِيهِ أَنَّ الْقُرْآنَ مُعْجِزَةُ النَّبِي صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَمَ المشاهدة بصدقه الدالة على نبوته فأبقاه الله على أمته وتولى حفظها بفضله حتى لا يزاد فيها ولا ينقص منها والمعجزات إما أن تكون معاينة إن كانت فعلا وإما أن تثبت تواترا إن كانت قولا ليقع العلم بها أو تنقل صورة الفعل فيها أيضا نقلا متواترا حتى يقع العلم بها كأن السامع لها قد شاهدها حتى تنبني الرسالة على أمر مقطوع به. الإمام أبو بكر بن العربي says something very powerful. He says, the Quran can only be called a Quran by way of mass transmission. And we will only call this Quran when it's mutawatir. It can't be called a Quran if it's not mutawatir. والمعنى فيه, he said, the meaning in this is that. And Al-Qur'an mu'jizatul nabi. The Quran is the Prophet's miracle. Prophets have come before and they came with miracles. Prophets came with miracles. Nabiullah Muhammad came with what? He came with the Quran as a miracle. جاء النبيون بالآيات فانصرمت وجئتنا بحكيم غير منصرم آيات كلما طال المدى جدد يبينهن جمال العتق والقدم. Nabiullah Muhammad came with a mu'jiza. His mu'jiza was what? The Quran. All the other prophets their mu'jiza, when they died or when they went, it went with them. Nabiullah Muhammad's mu'jiza is the Quran. Okay, he's saying that the mu'jiza, this mu'jiza, this miracle that Nabiullah Muhammad came with, which is the Quran, is there to prove his prophecy. And a miracle has to be based on something which every single body can either see or mass transmission. And if I say to you, I saw someone just do a miracle, they're going to be like, are you the only one who saw it? Yeah, okay. They're not going to believe it. In order to believe in this miracle, large number of people have to transmit that miracle, that they saw it, they were there, they saw it happening. Or else it's the value of it being a miracle is going. Or you had to have been there yourself to see it. The Quran, we were not there when it came down on the Prophet. So how are we going to consider it to be a miracle unless it has come to us through mass transmission? Large number of people are saying that we heard it from the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And that's a very powerful point Abu Bakr ibn al-Arabi rahimahullah pointed out. Yani those people who are saying that the Quran doesn't have to be mutawatir are basically, they are taking away, either intentionally or unintentionally, the ijaz of the Quran. That the Quran is a mu'jiza sent from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That the Quran is a mu'jiza sent down unto the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this, inshallah ta'ala, first point was to just give you the consensus of the a'immatul Islam wal Muslimin, what they said regarding the Quran and the qira'at being mutawatir. Inshallah ta'ala, I have four more episodes to go into more details proving that the Quran is mutawatir. And the ones who've said otherwise, whether they be Muslims or non-Muslims, that their view is shad, la yultafatu ilayhi. We don't look at it, we don't give it weight. That's inshallah ta'ala what my first episode on this doubt is going to be, inshallah ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. I'll see you guys inshallah ta'ala in the next episode. BarakAllahu feekum wa jazakumullahu khaira.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.